looking for as many as 11. We'll take 8 as we get set to go green. Top 4 move off to the main event. So we go green out of turn number 4, and we're underway. MBD's working the low side. Up top, Casey Haney did not make the call, so that moves Steve Russell up, and Russell will battle for the lead down the back straightaway. Steve Russell works the high side to his inside. It's going to be the 44 of D's, and Russell will be your leader of lap number 1. Steve Russell leads the way out of turn at number 4. Look out, we got a spinner up in turns 1 and 2, and that's going to be Langley in car number 19. He's going to get it fired up, though. We don't need no stinking caution. We're going to stay green. Long as he gasses her up, because the field's coming. Ah, the dreaded caution. Well, we had another spinner. Russell jumps to the lead. Cliff Ross back in the second spot, in the third spot. They work down the back straightaway. Burgess working his way up through the field. Back in the fourth spot now, the hot seat, Tim Dees in car number 44. Now we got a battle for the lead. Cliff Ross comes after Steve Russell, the Pontotoc Pirate, down the back straightaway. They'll complete lap 5 of 15 off turn at number 4, and now Cliff Ross up. Nope, it's going to be Steve Russell, your leader. Good battle for the lead. Meanwhile, Burgess from the back of the pack up to 3rd, and now in the 4th spot, Tim Dees. We got one slow down the front straightaway, and we'll see if the caution can fix it. And maybe it will, maybe it won't. We'll find out. Brent Dillon with trouble in cart number 7. Looking for the green flag out of 4. The Pontotoc Pirate back on the glide pedal. They'll head off into turns 1 and 2. Cliff Ross in 2nd. Tyler Burgess works the cushion off 2 down the back straightaway. Meanwhile, we got a battle for the 4th and final transfer side by side as they work off turn at number 4. And Dees has still got it, but Aaron Miller's turning up the heat. Meanwhile, Cliff Ross trying to find a way around Steve Russell as they work lap 7 down the backstretch. Off into turns 3 and 4, and we got a new leader. Cliff Ross goes to a top spot. Steve Russell bobbled just a little bit. He'll try to get his feet back under him, but he's got to deal with Tyler Burgess in car number 2. Meanwhile, Dees rides back and forth. Halfway home, 8 laps down, 7 to go in this one. 8 in the book, 7 laps remain. Your top 4 cars stretching it out on the field with Ross at the point in car number C20. And we got a spinner over in turn number 4. That'll be Will Ross. That'll draw the caution with 8 laps complete. 8 laps complete, 7 to go. All right, looking for Cliff Ross to bring us back to the green flag out of 4. 7 laps to go, top 4 to the main event. And we're back underway. Steve Russell ahead of steam. He's going to try to find a way back to the lead as they work through 1 and 2. Burgess to the inside of Russell, though. Good battle for the runner-up spot. Back and forth, it's Dees. Langley trying to get into the show. Oh, Russell shoves down in turns 3 and 4, and we're 3 wide per second. Oh, look out, Tim Dees from a transfer to the infield. Tough break, 9 laps down, 6 to go, and Tim Dees sitting in the infield. He was in a transfer spot, and now he is sitting in the sippy hole in the infield in car number 44. Tough break for Tim Dees. Had that 4th and final transfer, and now he finds himself in the infield with 6 laps to go. Green flag back underway, 9 laps down, 6 to go, and Cliff Ross gets a good restart. Off into turns 1 and 2. Now Burgess goes after Russell for that 2nd spot. Oh, Aaron Miller out of the transfer to a 4-wheel free slide. 10 laps complete, and he is going to draw the caution. 10 down, 5 to go, Cliff Ross. This one's turned into a bit of a marathon. We'll see if we can get these last 5 laps complete. Meanwhile, Dees from the back of the field trying to race into the transfer spot. He'll take over 4th going into turns 1 and 2. Will Ross from the back up to fifth. Meanwhile, Steve Russell and Tyler Burgess having a good battle for position number two with 11 down, four to go. Burgess into second. Russell back to third. Russell trying to get ahead of steam. Out front, Cliff Ross driving away from it. It'll be 13 down, two to go off turn number four. Burgess will go up top. He'll slip back as Dees will go past him with two to go. Now Burgess in the final transfer. Will Ross outside looking in. Aaron Miller, Thomas Langley, and Brent Dillon round out the field. White flag in there. One more time around the speedway for your leader, Cliff Ross. Steve Russell in second, Tim Dees in the third spot. Fourth's gonna be Tyler Burgess. Aaron Miller's gonna loop it around out of turn number four as they'll race back to the checkered flag. And Cliff Ross will take the win in NeSmith Chevrolet B main number one. Steve Russell comes home in second, Tim Dees in third. Tyler Burgess, your fourth and final transfer. So your fourth and final transfer will be car number 2B of Tyler Burgess in third after having to go to the back. The 44 of Tim Dees in second. The Pontotoc Pirates, Steve Russell in car 72. And your winner in car number 20, it'll be Cliff Ross. That's your four transfers out of NeSmith Chevrolet. Late model B-Main number 1, B-Main number 2 coming up next.
They're locked, loaded, and ready to go. 15 more laps, four more cars do transfer to the main event here tonight. Here they come. They're in the boxy on the gas, and we're underway as Josh Hush leads them down. Chase Washington looking to the inside of Cale Finley. That'll open the door for Mark Stokes as well. Here they come, three wide. We got caution. Did not get in the tool time starting box, the race director Adam Stewart said, so they'll bring them back and shoot them at us one more time here before they fired them up, so race director Adam Stewart called the start back. Here they come again. They're in the box. They're on the gas, and we're underway. Here they come. Only four cars transferred. Hush out front, Finley in second, Chase Washington third, Mark Stokes and Terry Wilson battling with that fourth spot. Wilson's got it. Stokes wants it. He's got it now down the back straightaway, side by side for the number one spot between Finley and Hush. Cale Finley, your leader, Josh Hush, Mark Stokes. And it's going to be Chase Washington. Here comes Terry Wilson in the 33 car. Caution. Looks like for the 11 car of Mullinex up by the wall down in turn number three. Big top, under the big top here, the Great American Circus, Lewis and Clark. Here they come, firing them up. Finley on the gas, and we're back underway. Washington out to the third spot. Hush back to fourth in the final transfer spot. He's going to get the third spot, try to get it back from Washington. And here comes Mark Stokes looking for the lead here. Mark Stokes trying to get that number one spot from Cale Finley as they go down the back straightaway. Stokes driving it hard, making contact, and Mark Stokes has hit the infield. Caution coming out. Cale Finley out front. Chase Washington, Josh Hush on row number two. And here they come, back to the green flag, and we're underway. Chase Washington, Josh Hush putting pressure on your leader, Cale Finley. And who's going to get the fourth spot? Matthew Brocato had it that time. Hunter Lewis on the move in the 7 car. See if Hunter Lewis can make something happen here. He's got to pass the 65 car of Bercato. And he'll have a transfer spot. Terry Wilson, Smurf Man, trying to make something happen as well in the 33. But your top three cars go off of 2 down the back straightaway. Chase Washington now the 2nd spot. Hush in 3rd. Bercato still in the 4th and final transfer spot as Cale Finley crosses the stripe with 9 complete, 6 to go. Oh, Nelly, they're fighting for that final transfer spot back here. Hunter Lewis not giving an inch in the 7. He's got to get around the 65 car. Abracato to get in the race. Josh Hush looking to the inside of Chase Washington. And looks like Hunter Lewis. He's going to track the inside here, try to make something happen. Cannot do it. Terry Wilson right there. Here comes Mark Stokes as well. In the number 2. Hunter Lewis to the inside of Bercato. He's going to have the 4th spot. And the 33 car of Wilson has put it on spin cycle. 12 laps complete, 3 laps to go. Back to the green flag here as Cale Finley leads him again down the front straightaway. Neil Baggett. Car number 21 car driven by Chase Washington. And we got trouble off of turn number 2. The 33 car of the Smurf Man, Terry Wilson, the track star, sits up in the door. Cale Finley, your leader. He'll fire him up here in turn number 4. He's on the gas. Here they come. Chase Washington, Josh Hush, Mark Stokes. Having to go to the rear of the field, trying to get that transfer spot, and he's got it right now off of turn number 2. Down in turn 3 they'll go. Stokes trying to make the show in the 2 car. And giving it up there to Matthew Bercato. White flag for Cale Finley. Chase Washington, Josh Hush. Matthew Bercato, Mark Stokes trying to get that spot. Here they come. And Finley wins it. Washington transfers along with Josh Hush and Matthew Bercato. The F36, the 21, the 25, and the 65 unofficially will transfer to the main event. Well, we're getting ready to go green here for 50 laps. Hunter Carroll and Randall Beckwith will bring the field of cars to the green flag. They're going to have Monty Skinner and Jamie Bolin right behind them, along with Evan Ellis and Jeremy Shaw. As they roll to the Tool Time starting box, they're in the box, they're on the gas, and here they come, race fans, down the front straightaway.
Hunter Carroll celebrating a birthday yesterday, and right now he leads this one out of turn 2, but he's got company. Here comes Beckwith, and back in 3rd, it's going to be Skinner. He's going to lead lap number 1 of 50. Carroll right there on the hub, Beckwith to his outside, and it's going to be Beckwith leading lap number 1.
Randall Beckwith, your leader, Hunter Carroll, Monty Skinner, Evan Ellis, Jamie Bolin, your top 5. And here comes Monty Skinner.
And Skinner now going to try to become the 2nd leader of this event. Good stuff in this one right now as the track's still in phenomenal shape. And Monty Skinner leads lap number 2.
Yep, the racetrack's good right now. Monty Skinner looks like he's got that capital race car working real good tonight. Probably some of the best runs I've seen him make here this year.
Right now he paces the way. Hunter Carroll in 2nd. Evan Ellis on the march in 3rd. Back within 4th, Jamie Bolin, keep an eye on him, back in the 5th spot. And it'll be Jeremy Shaw in 6th as they're running all over the speedway. And Marcus Minga slows in 2, trying to get to the infield, down the back straightaway, not going to happen, caution will fly.
problems with the 19 car of Marcus Minga. He'll stop on the back straightaway. Here they come, off of turn number four, the Saraland, Alabama driver, Monty Skinner, still out front. Evan Ellis in the second spot, Hunter Carroll, Jamie Boland, and Randall Beckwith, your top five cars as they run right now. And here they come, still Skinner stretching the lead out now to about a little over a second lead over Evan Ellis. Carroll hanging into the third spot. We've got cars all back through the field, moving and shaking.
Right now, Skinner on cruise control, driving away from him. Ellis up into the second spot as Carroll into third has right now Monty Skinner having a good run in that Capital 00.
Monty Skinner a little bit away from lap traffic right in front of him as he enters turn number three. Evan Ellis, the very right race car, right behind him along with Hunter Carroll, the track star. Kyle Shaw, the track star, the very right of Randall Beck with your top five. And Jeremy Shaw in the sixth spot, the brand new GRT race car.
Well, now your leader is going to enter lap traffic with 10 on the board, 40 laps to go, 10 down, 40 to go. And Monty Skinner into lap traffic as he's got a comfortable 2.9 second advantage.
That's right, but lap traffic will slow the leader up as he tries to get around the 65 car of Brocato. Matthew Brocato. He's got the 25 Josh Hush right in front of him. He's not going to pull a Davenport. Nope.
He thought about it.
He did. He mashed the gas and hit the brake. So, and here he comes. He'll split them down in turn number three and four.
He's got a hot rod here tonight.
He does. He's got a race car right now.
12 laps complete. And right now, Monty Skinner picking him up and laying him down. 2 second advantage over Evan Ellis with Kyle Shaw, Hunter Carroll, and Randall Beckwith rounding out your top five.
Your leader, Monty Skinner, putting DJ Brassfield a lap down. Ellis right there trying to make up some ground as well.
Lap traffic continues to be in front of your leader as he reels them in. Right now, Chase Washington, last car on the lead lap. He runs in 20th, but that might not last for long as here comes Monty Skinner knocking on the back door. As we come around to complete lap number 15, Skinner's got to be careful not to push the issue too hard. And he'll clear Chase Washington off turn number four. Tyler Burge is his next victim. Meanwhile, his lead continues to grow. We got a tangle up here. Jamie Boland.
Oh, yeah, Jamie Boland.
And maybe,
can't see the number. Coming back to the green flag here, it's Monty Skinner out front. Evan Ellis and Kyle Shaw now your top three. Hunter Carroll back to the fourth spot. And Randall Beckwith running out your top five.
Monty Skinner leads the way now, 16 laps complete. Good 2 and 3 wide battles behind him. Here comes Kyle Shaw, number two, going to work on Beckwith for that third spot. Hunter Carroll now moves up into the fray, back and forth. And Jeremy Shaw on the move as well. He'll go after his cousin, Kyle Shaw, for position number five.
So Still Monty Skinner stretching that lead out. Evan Ellis runs in the second spot. Has the Barry Wright car of Ellis got anything for the Capital car of Skinner? We're about halfway through. Well, looks like Monty Skinner has caught lap traffic of Bricado and Huss.
It's going to be Evan Ellis' chance to reel him in. Next time by is going to be halfway as 24 laps are complete. Meanwhile, it's going to be the Shaw cousins on the right now battling it out. Kyle Shaw.
Yep.
He's got a good run right now. Jeremy Shaw to his outside.
Can Evan Ellis get around the lap traffic here? The 73 driver, has he got something for Monty Skinner? He's got to split the lap cars. Here he comes down off of turn number two down the back straightaway. Evan Ellis moving and shaking in the 73 car. Here he comes. Monty Skinner, your leader to flag stand. Here comes Evan Ellis.
Ellis has got company, too. He's got the Shaws coming with him. We're going to have a good battle for the second spot as they're trying to reel in your leader, Monty Skinner. It'll be 23 to go out of turn number four.
Kyle Shaw, Jeremy Shaw, trying to get around the lap cars of Brassfield and Huss.
Four wide.
Oh, it could be dangerous. Grant Pearl in the sixth spot. Beckwith still holds downfield. Matt Henderson in seventh. Dett Wilder in eighth. Hunter Carroll, Bryant Marsh, your top ten.
Good battles around the speedway as Evan Ellis now 1.3 seconds behind your leader, Monty Skinner. And it'll be 21 laps remaining this time out of turn number four.
That's right, 28 laps are complete. 29 now as your leader crosses. Monty Skinner, Evan Ellis, looks like maybe catching up just a little bit, only 1.3 seconds behind. And Ellis closing the gap here. Evan Ellis closed the gap there. 1.1 seconds that time by.
As right now, Skinner's got a lot of lap cars in front of him. Just one lap car in between Ellis and Monty Skinner. And now Kyle Shaw's going to come after Evan Ellis. That's a battle for position.
That is. Battle for position. Lap car of Tim Dees. Can't Evan Ellis needs to go to the outside. And he does. Here comes Ellis. Can he hold on? Shaw on the bottom. Ellis around the top is going to be Kyle Shaw in second now.
Good battle. Kyle Shaw started back in second. Ellis not going to give up that easy. He's going to try to wrestle it back away from him down the back straightaway.
Down the backside is going to be Ellis and Shaw battling for second. Here they come. And double E got it back that time by.
Jeremy Shaw's reeling them both in, and he's running a totally different groove than they are. Meanwhile, Monty Skinner, 1.3 second advantage at the front of the pack.
Here's your leader, Skinner, Ellis, and Shaw. Shaw that time has the second spot. Jeremy Shaw working around the concrete. He's got a Davenport line going right there.
He does. He's driving the wheels off that.
But
as Tyler Burgess is going to slow. And that's going to give us 34 laps complete, maybe 35, with 15 laps remaining.
34 complete. 34. They'll go back to the last completed lap.
Well, 16 laps remaining. Can Monty Skinner keep it rolling as he comes back to the green? We're back underway.
And here comes Ellis.
four wide back in the pack. And Evan Ellis, like you said, Ross, getting ahead of steam. Can he get to your leader? They take second back away from Kyle Shaw.
Off of turn number four. Here they come. Ellis goes to the top. Has he got something up there? He's got the second spot back.
Getting ahead of steam right through the middle of the racetrack. Now he'll let it drift to the top. Grant Pearl in fourth after an early race melee.
Grant Pearl moving and shaking as well. Jeremy Shaw now in the top five.
Beckwith back there in a six-spot battle. And Deadwilder's come to life as well. We got some movers and shakers late in this
one. That's what I'm saying. Scott Deadwilder, another capital race car moving up through the field as well. And Beckwith slides to the top. Evan Ellis closing the gap on our leader. Here he comes. Less than a second now separates Evan Ellis and Monty Skinner.
And it's going to be a dozen laps to go out of turn number four.
And Kyle Shaw will be your second place car this time, Bob.
Good stuff right now in front of the pack. Laps taken away. The NeSmith Chevrolet Dirt League Model main event. 3,000 on the line for the 50-lapper.
11 laps to go this time by for Monty Skinner. Grant Pearl, he is moving. Making a bobble down
close.
Turn one and two. He's on that Brandon Overton team, too.
That's right. He's part of that. He spends a lot of time turning wrenches, only gets to race a limited schedule, making the most of it here tonight, trying to get into a podium spot with 10 laps remaining.
Monty Skinner out front, Kyle Shaw, Evan Ellis, your top three. Now Grant Pearl's going to take the top third spot from Ellis, but can he get it back? Jeremy Shaw, the Shawtown Flyer, working around the hub.
Shaw's got a good race car.
He's got a fantastic race car. Jeremy Shaw fourth, Evan Ellis back to fifth.
Jeremy may win this race. He is turning some fast laps right now, and he's wound up around the top. Nobody else is up there.
He's about 2 seconds faster than your leader right now.
As now we've got 8 laps remaining. There's plenty of time for Shaw to get there, and he's going to push the throttle through the four.
He's got the hot rod. He's the fastest car out there right now in the top five.
Last time by, he was 4/10 better than your leader. And now he'll go to the outside of Grand Pearl. Running out of time, though. It's go time.
Yeah, you've got 7 to go, 43 complete.
And now lap traffic. This could be just what Jeremy Shaw wants.
Yeah, that's right. He's going to be right behind your leader. Jeremy Shaw, fastest car out there in the top five right now.
Yes.
And Monty Skinner and Kyle Shaw battling.
They're battling it out for the lead.
Side by side. Here comes Kyle Shaw.
5 laps to go, side by side for the lead.
Grant Pearl in the third spot.
Yeah.
Jeremy Shaw trying to take that spot from Grant Pearl.
And now it Shaw's up into
wow,
third.
Wow, here they come, the first and second place cars. Who's it going to be still? Monty Skinner by nose.
4 laps to go, Ross, and Jeremy Shaw's trying to reel in your leaders as they work through lap traffic. Grant Pearl right there. Kyle Shaw takes the lead down the back straightaway.
The 2S car, your leader. Monty Skinner's led it most of the night here, but Kyle Shaw now stretching it out over Monty Skinner. Jeremy Shaw still sits back in that third spot, but he's the fastest race car except for Kyle Shaw right now in the top three.
Well, Jeremy gave up the top, and that's where he's making up ground. Look at this traffic in front of your leaders, and there's 2 laps to go.
Lap cars all across the racetrack in front of your leader, Kyle Shaw and Monty Skinner. Can they make something happen? Skinner closes the gap, but Kyle Shaw will open it up by about 2 car lengths here in turn number 3 and 4 as he rolls around the 44 car of Tim Dees.
White flag in there. Final time around the speedway for Kyle Shaw.
Can he hold on? Looks like he's pretty well got it. Monty Skinner slides up the racetrack. Steve Russell backs up. Here comes Jeremy Shaw. And the checkered flag in the air.
Kyle Shaw takes the win.
Kyle Shaw wins it.
Monty Skinner in second, Jeremy Shaw in third, Grant Pearl in fourth, and Scott Deadwilder in fifth. What a race.
Wow. Kyle Shaw, the Millport Missile, has won the big one here. This is one of his biggest wins of his career. The track star driver from Millport, Alabama, has took the win here at the Magnolia State Cotton Picking 100 weekend. He'll be presented with the